Good morning, everyone. It's Lori McGuire with RE/MAX McGuire Team. And now in chapter three, the author, James Clear, talks about how with forming a habit, there's four different things that we go through. In fact, there's what's called the cue. There's the craving. There is response and the result. See, I'm remembering all this. Anyway, and what that means is, okay, so let's just say you're trying to form a great habit. Okay, everyone? Okay, and I'll give you an example. Okay, I bought a little ticker. Okay, if you see this little ticker, and it's on my keychain, but what this ticker is all about is, you could use it for a lot of different things. This could help you form a new habit. For instance, my goal is to call at least 10 new prospects every day, or at least go through my lead database and connect with people I haven't connected with in a long time, or past clients. So what makes it fun is I have this little clicker, and every time I make that call to someone, and I connect, I click it. And it's just, I know it's like a silly little game, but that's the cue. So this is what's called the cue. And the cue is, I want to get this to 10 every day. And the craving, which is the second part of the habit, forming a habit, is, you know, so I see this green, and by the way, these come in different colors on Amazon. But the craving is I want it to get to 10 because I'm going to get a reward when I finish my habit. Then after that, there's a response. So the response is, so, you know, the cue is I see this. The craving is I want my reward at the end. And so the craving is, okay, I'm going to get on that phone right away. I want to accomplish this right now. And then response. And then the last thing is the result. And the result is I get the person on the phone. I have to leave a message or whatever. And I feel really great about myself. And I feel great about connecting with that person. Maybe we haven't spoken in a long time. And for instance, yesterday I did it and I was able to connect with two people I hadn't talked to in a long time and set two appointments. So it was wonderful, just having a little, you know, things like this. And I initially did not buy this for prospecting, which is really funny. I thought of it just the other day to use it for prospecting. And by the way, ladies, I bought you all one. Okay, and I brought them into the office. So anyway, but they're really fun. You can use it for anything. I bought this because I was trying to form another habit. And the other habit was to, I am a runner. And by the way, that's a part of this book. When you are forming a habit, since I just started running, I used to be a runner in high school, since I started running really in January, and it's trail running, and I have done a few ultra running events, but I now say I am an ultra runner. So anyway, but in regards to the book, they say, whatever you want to be, who you want to become, you start saying you are that person now. So I say, I am an ultra runner. Even after I only ran my first ultra running event, which is anything over a marathon, I was saying to everyone, I mean, I didn't mean to boast, but I'm an ultra runner, because then it was embedded in my subconscious mind too. And it was like nothing for me to go out and run 20 miles because I'm an ultra runner, you know? But I initially bought this for my running. So with ultra running, the thing I love about it is it's not about how fast you are, because otherwise I'd have a lot of problems. It's about, you know, what it's all about is, you know, usually you like walk the high heels and then you run the flats and you run the downhills. That's how I learned at the very beginning, just to get through my first ultra marathon. Well, now I've become a little bit more competitive, so I want to run the uphills as much as possible. So I now count, the way I was able to figure that out is I started, what motivated me is I'm into numbers. So I started counting for every two steps, that would be one, two, three. So when I would go up these high mountains, my goal was just to get to 100. And then my goal was to get to 200 without stopping. Then 300, I got up to 1,000 and I was able to go up this huge mountain without stopping. So my endurance has gotten so much better just in the last couple months. And now I can, you know, do a lot more running. So I thought, well, instead of having to figure it all out in my head, I'm just gonna carry this with me and start ticking it as I'm running. Now I haven't done that yet, ladies, but we'll see if it works. But for right now, I'm using it for prospecting and it's really awesome. Okay, so a couple things I wrote down, and then I promise this will not be a long video. The conscious mind can only hold one thought at a time. So, you know, it's very important to form habits. And the habit, your habits, you could do like multiple tasks when you have all these habits, because you're using your unconscious mind, your subconscious mind, because it's, you know, just automatically doing things. And, but if you don't form a lot of really good habits, then you're literally just, you know, having to think about every little thing as you're doing it. And then, the other things are, so just remember with, it's the cue, which triggers the brain. The craving is your desire. The response, which is the actual habit, and the reward, which is your end goal. And a habit has to be all four, and that's called a habit loop, which is really important. And the last thing, and then I'm gonna definitely say, have a wonderful day after this, because I'm trying to make these videos short. There's for positive habits, you wanna make the cue very obvious. So whatever that cue is, like if you're trying to establish a habit, like running in the morning, or exercising, you make that cue very, very obvious. And that is perhaps it's, you know, a cup of coffee. So you have that cup of coffee in the morning, but you're not gonna have that cup of coffee until you are dressed in your exercise clothes. And so it's very, very obvious, because you always have to have that cup of coffee in the morning. So you're going to be in exercise clothes first. And then make the craving attractive. Make the response easy. So it's very easy because you have your exercise clothes already set up the night before. And then make the reward satisfying, because maybe you reward yourself obviously with coffee, and then when you're back from exercise, you reward yourself with something else, but maybe not chocolate cake or anything like that. And then for breaking bad habits, this is really important. Inversion of positive habits. So make the cue invisible. So, okay, so what's a bad habit? What's a bad habit you girls have? See, no one wants to admit their bad habits. Okay, see, that's just it. Okay, so going to bed late. Okay, so how can we make that invisible? Okay, I'll tell you what. This is what I did. When I started going to bed earlier, I have what's called Hue in my property, my house. And so all my lights turn off at a certain time. So then I know that is my time that I go to bed, you know, or they start dimming at a certain time and then they all turn off. So that's kind of like, you're kind of making it invisible. So it's like showing you that, okay, it's time to start going to bed. Okay. And then the craving, make it unattractive to go out, to stay up late. Because you start setting your alarm clock for early in the morning. So then it's very unattractive to stay up late, because you're going, oh my gosh, this is so tough. You know, just like little things like or you could think of something else that's, you know, you're staying up late, but to do that, you have to exercise to stay up late, you know, but that's going to probably hurt you with your sleep. And then response. Make that response difficult if it's a bad habit. So the response is, let's just see, what would be a response for staying up late? That would be, the response is always that you're actually staying up late. So you make that difficult, and that is where your TV turns off automatically, or your cell phone you can have your social media and everything, you can't access that. You keep your cell phone downstairs and you go upstairs. So you can't access your cell phone. So there's things like that. I've done these kind of things. And then the reward, make unsatisfying, because remember, you're trying to get rid of this bad habit. Make the reward very unsatisfying. Staying up late, just make it really unsatisfying. Just like, you know, because you have to get rid of this bad habit. So, okay, you're staying up late and you're doing something that you really don't want to do. Like you're doing laundry all night. You know, something that's really going to get you away from this bad habit. But I'm a firm believer, to get rid of a bad habit, you have to switch over to a positive habit that will want you to get rid of bad habits. You know, for instance, if you're overeating, the best way to get rid of overeating is you start exercising and you start, you know, feeling good about yourself, then you won't want to eat as much. So I'm a firm believer in that. Anyway, I know I've gone past my time. I really appreciate your support. And I have the most wonderful team. Half my team is here right now. And we just had a mini meeting. And I'm so appreciative of each and every one of them. We've had the most amazing year ever. And I am so appreciative of our clients and our friends and everything. So thank you again, and have a great day. Okay, bye-bye.